Hello student, welcome to Geographer Thinking. I hope you are fine. In this lecture, I am discussing precipitation. So what I am discussing in this topic is what is precipitation, precipitation forming process and types of precipitation. The fall of moisture from the atmosphere is called precipitation. The next is precipitation forming process. The next topic is precipitation forming process. Two separate mechanisms are believed to be principally responsible for producing precipitation particle, and they are ice crystal process and collision process. The ice crystal process include when a cloud contains both ice particle and water droplets. The water droplets tend to evaporate and then sublimate to directly on the ice crystal. The pressure over the ice crystal are lower than water vapor. The ice crystal grow at the expense of liquid droplets. The ice crystal become larger and often join together to form a snowflake. Most rainfall and snowfall in the mid-latitude are formed by the ice crystal process. The next is collision process. The process requires some liquid droplets to be larger than others, which happen when there are giant condensation nuclei. As they fall, the larger droplets collide and join with the smaller one. But narrowly missing smaller droplets may still be caught up in the wake of large ones and drawn to them. In their case, the large droplets grow at the expense of the smaller ones and soon become heavy enough to fall on the ground. The next is form of precipitation. These different form of precipitation, the first is dew. The moisture deposited on the earth surface or on subject near to the earth surface, such as blade of grass. When due to radiation, the earth has cooled, the lower layer of troposphere blew the dew point and the water vapor present has condensed into drops. The greater the amount of water vapor in the air, the lower the temperature of the ground, the more abundant the dew. Thus, the calm weather and clear sky provide the best condition for the production of dew. The next is mist. The amass of water drops present in the lower layer of the atmosphere caused by the condensation of water vapor in the air and giving a moderate reduction of visibility. The next is fog. Fog is simply a cloud on the ground. There is no difference between a cloud and a fog except the location and formation of process. There are two types of fog. The first is radiational fog and the second is advectional fog. The radiation fog results from the radiational cooling, usually at night, and advectional fog can develop when warm, moist air moves horizontally over a cold surface, such as snow-covered ground or cool ocean currents like Labrador Current near Newfoundland. The next topic is frost. When the air temperature has fallen as far as below 0 degree centigrade, the particle of frozen moisture formed on or upon object of the surface and is known as frost. There are two common types of frost. One is glassed frost, which form on object onto which rain is falling in an atmosphere having a freezing temperature. The other form is hoar frost, when the water vapor directly solidified an object like ice crystal without passing through the liquid straight car sublimation. The next is snow. Consists of masses of ice grow directly from the water vapor of the air. When air temperature is below freezing, the mechanism of snowfall is somewhat is the same as that of the rainfall. Sleet. Consisting of mixture of snow and rain, the ice pellet, which consists of either of frozen raindrop or snow which has partly melted and has been refrozen when falling through a cold layer of air near the earth's surface. The next topic is glass, a coating of smooth ice, sometimes of considerable thickness, which form on the object onto which rain is falling into atmosphere having a temperature below the freezing point. It is formed too when a warm damp and follow an extremely cold spell, the moisture condensation then freezing on surface which are still below 0 degree centigrade. The next is hail. Hail consists of rounded lumps of ice having an internal structure of concentric layer, much like an onion. Ordinary, the ice is not clear, but has a frosted appearance. Hailstones range from 0.5 to 5 cm in diameter and may be extremely destructive. The next is drizzle. Drizzle rainfall in which the water drops extremely small, like a fine spray. The diameter of droplet is about 0.2 to 0.5 millimeter. Next topic is rain, the most important and most common form of precipitation. When separate water droplets fall to the earth from the clouds having a diameter more than 0.5 millimeter. The rain is mostly formed by the cumulonimbus clouds. And condensation of water vapor is talked about the different mechanism, and on these basis rain can be divided into subtypes like physical orographic rainfall and convectional rainfall, frontal or cyclonic rainfall, and coastal rainfall. So this is the overall topic of precipitation, and don't forget to subscribe this channel and like this video, and suggest me any topic in the comment. Thank you so much.